Here is a NodeMCU ESP8266 based Wi-Fi module. There are so many projects for this little board and a lot of things can be done by this. And now I want to keep my NodeMCU always with me, but also with its own power. I also have this TWS case and there is no earpiece on it, only the case. It has battery, it has backup, it has a USB-C port for charging. So I think if I can put my NodeMCU in here between the cover and main box like this, maybe I have to cut all of this pin or I have to make lot of hole in this case. So this pin is go through the hole and fit inside this box. Anyway, after fitting this, I need to give it power, and of course I have to install a off switch for this because I don't want to run this module all the day continuously. So this module can run 5 volt in this port. Here is a ground and voltage in. We can put here 5 to 20 volt, and here is another pin ground and 3.3 volt. We can run this board with only 3.3 volt, and I think this is good for me because in this case I have a lithium battery, 3.7 volt lithium battery, 4.2 volt when it fully charged. So what I can do, I will use a buck converter. I have a extremely small buck converter. Okay, so I will use this buck converter to run this module with 3.3 volt. Converter will get power from the battery and supply 3.3 volt to this board. And for control the power on off switch, I will use this little switch. The switch is white, case is also white. I will put the switch in here inside the case, and in this position I will make a hole so the switch will come out a little bit here and I can on off. So let's see what can I do. I made these holes for inside the pin and I thought the module will fit in here, but it's not fit in here. So I have to remove these black plastic parts from this pin. So maybe that will help. Almost done. So now we'll try if it. I think I have to do one more thing. I have to trim this pin because there is a battery and a circuit in here, so this pin cannot fully insert. So I think it will feel okay. After cutting the pins, now it perfectly fit in the compartment. Now see, easy. No one cannot guess what's inside. Now the challenge is to put this switch, install this switch. Let's see what can I do. I think I can put this switch in here, yeah, between the board and body, and switches it will like this. I have to make a hole in here, then I will put it. I made a hole. I think it will be okay. If not, I'll make it bigger. Now I have to open this board. Finally, I can fit this switch in here. For this reason, I had to trim some plastic from the switch so it can fit in here and the board can also fit in its place. You see, there is still some problem. Because of this switch, the board is not fit in this position, but this is okay, it's not a big problem. So now I will solder everything back together. At first the switch, then the DC to DC buck converter, after that finally this NodeMCU. First step is done, switch soldered, and I'll place this switch in position. I have to trim here a little bit. Oops, I made a hole. Now I screw this. Oops. Why are you light up? screw goes in its place, switch installed. Now this two wire will go through this little hole, negative, positive. Now we can close this. Problem after problem. There is little bit gap here because of the switch. Now it is almost close and not noticeable. So we are going forward, power output here through the switch, 0 volt. Solder it in positive, in negative. Okay, input positive, then input negative. Then we will see the output, 2.62 volt. We have to do something. 3 volt. I need 3.3. What's the problem? Now it is tuned at 3.3 volt. This is perfect for my NodeMCU. Now output cable soldering, output positive. Everything almost done. I soldered and taped this buck converter and put it here. Now I will solder this NodeMCU and everything will be okay. I will use this ground and this 3.3. Okay, now this is the final step, soldering to the board. Oh, positive, negative. Now see what happened. Volt is in. This is the problem. Cannot provide 3 volt. Can provide only 1.8% from the battery. Maybe battery is not good. Battery. Through the buck converter, it cannot provide proper voltage to run this module. So now I will try to power this direct from the battery without buck converter in this voltage in pin and ground. This pin can handle 5 to 20 volt, but I don't know if it can work with 4 volt. Let's see. First desolder them, then ground. No, from this side, negative soldered, positive also. Now we'll see the truth. Power on. Let's see, is it working or not? Oh, it's working. Here is see, power off, connection failed. Power on. This is our NodeMCU. It is connected, it's working fine. So our project is successfully done. It's working fine. This is our NodeMCU with backup battery and it's working. Thank you for your time.